Hello and welcome, Matteo here. Eric and I have fun recreating a game mechanic from Fortnite. We have made the battle bus and character landing mechanics in Unity. Speaking of Fortnite, I played the first 2 seasons and then I left unbeaten. Or maybe not.
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
First thing first, with great pleasure we have discovered that in Fortnite there is a Nutcracker skin. Our mascot Nutty is very happy about it and a bit jealous. In fact, we could not miss the chance to create a humanoid version of Nutty that fits the graphic style. But at the end of a long sculpting session in Blender, the result is concerning. The creature is power, very agile and a good dancer. But the face, let's just say it's a bit creepy. Not to mention this track shoot. Anyway, once the character model is ready, instead of rigging it manually in Blender, we save a lot of time thanks to the Mixamore auto-rigging tool. This rigs your character for free in no time. We import the result in Unity and we are ready to animate it. Animate a character is a long but relaxing task. We first identify the single animation we need from the game and we recreate them in Unity by animating the single bones of the character. The character landing mechanic can be subdivided in 2 main phases, a freefall mode and a glider mode. The resulting animator reflects this. We have a branch tree that handles the freefalling states and transitions and a block with 3 animations that handle the glider mode. A branch tree is very handy when you need smooth transitions. In general, you use it for very tight related animations that most of the time are binded to the same controller's input. Good examples are jump and falling animations, walk and run animations, and so on. By pressing the spacebar button, we open the glider and we exit from the blend tree. We stay in this new position until we press space again, returning to the blend tree. To create and texture the glider, we use Blender. Besides animations, when falling there are a lot of rotations and movement to take into account. To handle them, we created a character controller script that listens for all the user inputs in the update method and makes the proper angle and movement calculations. The root game object has a rigid body component and we use it to physically move the character in space and rotate it on itself. For all the other rotations, we act directly on the transform component of the first child game object. Inputs are A, D, W, and space. Pressing space, we open the glider, adding the possibility to move back and forth. To modify the fall speed of a game object, the easiest way is to use the drag property of the rigid body. When it falls normally, we use a drag value of 3, we change it to 0 to fall faster and to 6 to fall even more slowly. Character is ready. Now the battle bus. To implement the battle bus, there are some things to notice. It spawns in a random edge of the map. It always moves from the spawn point toward the center of the map plus a random offset, and you can press space to land only when you're inside the map area. You can jump when the battle bus is still over the sea. An easy way to spawn a target around a perimeter is to use the 3D coordinate of the world cleverly. In fact, if we include our game map inside a square that originates with its lower left corner from 0, 0, 0, we find edges coordinate easily and we can just pick a random position across it. Once in place, we also pick a random direction toward the center of the map plus a random offset and we start to move the bus. The land area is marked thanks to a big invisible collider. When the battle bus passes through the collider, it raises an event informing interested objects. In particular, the game manager enabled the possibility to press space to jump from the bus, activating the player. We implement events with scriptable objects. If you want deepen the argument, we advise you this video created by the talented guys of Thousand Ant. To replace this ugly cube, we download this battle bus from Sketchfab. Since it's not texturized, we create a simple texture in Blender. We also download from Sketchfab a low-res Fortnite map. Another important task is setting up game cameras properly. We install the Cinemachine package and use two free-look virtual camera. This kind of camera provides the possibility to move using the mouse or any custom button around three customizable orbits. With this camera we can turn around the flying bus exactly as we do in Fortnite. The second camera is always a free look camera, but it uses only the mouse Y position to orbit vertically, and it is set to target ahead and hard look to always stay behind the character game object. When we press the space button to jump from the bus, we change the priority order of the virtual cameras so that they switch automatically from one to the other. Now the polish phase. To improve visual look we make different things. We install the post-processing package from the package manager and set various effects like bloom and color grading. We add tray renders to simulate the air cutted by the hands and feet. We create a particle system to simulate the flame above the bus. We download a very cool Unity package from the store containing a customizable Skybox. We also add a water shader. This is the final result. What do you think about it? If you enjoyed the video, subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications. This really helps us to grow faster and reach more people. We really enjoy recreating content from Fortnite. Tell us in the comment below if you would like to see other game mechanics from the game. A fantastic creepy natty is waiting for new adventures. See you in the next video. Bye!